ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Brandon Wardell. City, the city you are listening to this in. Thanks, it's so great to be here in the city that the listener is listening to this in. I'm in that city. Thank you so much for having me. My name is Brandon Wardell, and I'm a comedian. And this is a comedy album, but it's an ASMR comedy album, so you need to listen to this on good headphones. By the way, a couple ground rules up top. Okay, one, if you're listening to this for any sort of like perverted reason, please stop. Please don't. This is not. I don't want anybody listening to this for any sort of like perverted reasons. Listening to this, if you want to laugh or if you want to relax, okay. If you want to listen to this and go to sleep, perfect. If you want to listen to this and have a laugh or like maybe just when I tell a joke, you're like, you know, you do one of those. You're like, you just exhale a little bit through your nose. That's great. That's what I'm looking for. But if you're some sort of pervert, you're listening to this for perverted reasons, cut it out.
about it.
I'm jealous of my gay friends because they've got the damn Grindr app, right? You just pull open your phone and you're like, ah, boy, am I horny. I want to fuck somebody. And then somebody else is like, oh yeah, I want to fuck you specifically, and I'm in the same room as you right now. And then you guys just go fuck. You know, like, I wish there was like a Grindr for guys like me. You know? Like, I wish there was like a Grindr for me to like fuck other straight dudes. Let's just do some quick breathing exercises as a crowd. It's a bad time to be a sex pervert, right? I mean, it was like a good time for hundreds of years. And then at some point within the last couple months, you know, they were like, oh, it's bad now. And you know, it's a bad time for women. It's a bad time for sex perverts. But I think it's an even harder time for DJs. And let me explain. Okay, basically, a lot of sex perverts have made great music. You know, R. Kelly, Nelly, etc. And so now, when you go to a club, and, you know, it's weird when a DJ plays sex perverts music, right? Like, I was at this party, and the DJ, he played a Nelly song, and I was like, oh, this is like a weird time to play a Nelly song. And then right after that, he played an R. Kelly song. And I was like, oh, it's weird to like play the R. Kelly song right after the Nelly song, right? And then after that, he just played a full Woody Allen album. Alright guys, give it up for the band one more time. One time, there was this show in LA, and I was on the lineup, but my name wasn't listed on any of the posters or anything, and it's the night of the show. Person running it calls me. They're like, hey, Brandon, there's not a lot of people here. Do you still want to come out? And I was like, yes, absolutely. And then I get there, and there's one person there. And it's an ex of mine that I hadn't talked to in a year. And the show was canceled because there was one person there. But I really wish let the show go on, and I really wish I did a set of just exclusively crowd work. Like, I just come out like, hey, so how's everybody in the crowd been doing since last year? Is anyone seeing anyone new? You in the front, hello. What's your name? Oh, wow, that's a funny name. What do you do? For a living. What do you do for a living?
Yeah, all right. You listen up, okay? This is my show. Right? This is my show right now. Don't try to make this about you. No, I get I brought you up on stage, but listen, this isn't a dialogue. Alright. You talk to me when I talk to you. I'm sorry. No, that really is that is a fascinating job. I'm not gonna you shouldn't feel insecure about that. You are a beautiful person. Don't talk about yourself like that. You're really great. No, that's you. You look good. Maybe this is moving too fast. No, I think we should, we should move in together.
Yeah?
I'll make dinner tomorrow. No, don't worry about it. No, I want to treat you. I like it. I like when you check in. Customary when you ask a father to let his daughter marry you to brush each other's hair, just dad to son. I'm your son now, and we should brush each other's hair. I'll start. Most beautiful dad hair I've ever seen in my life.
Wow, this is the most beautiful son-in-law hair I've ever seen in my life. I love my son-in-law.
Thanks, Dad. I love my dad.
I love my son-in-law.
I love my dad. Ugh. Hey, babe, this is kind of hard to tell you, but I think I'm in love with your dad. No, it's fine. No, stop. Don't cry. Please. Don't cry. No, it's fine. Nothing happened. No, nothing happened. We just brushed each other's hair. And it was really beautiful. He has the most beautiful dad hair I've ever seen in my life. No, but I love you. I love you so much. I love you so much. Please, go back to your seat. Go back to your seat now. I have a show to do. Please, thank you. This isn't a dialogue. This is my show. Go back to your seat. Oh, I'm sorry, guys. This is unprofessional, but I just noticed a bunch of lint on all of my clothes. And so I do have a lint roller on me. So I'm just going to use that real quick. Sorry to take so many breaks from the material. going to lint roll my damn ass. That's comedy, baby. That's what real comedy is. This is an art form. I'm lint rolling my damn ass. Now that I've lint rolled, I think it's important to apply some rosewater facial spray. Here's the twist. I'm spraying it on my damn ass. Folks. That's a callback. Oh, this is weird. Normally they wait until after comedians perform to pay them, but tonight, for some reason, they've given me all of my money already. They've already given me all of my money on stage in the middle of my act. It's a lot of money, but I don't do this for money. I do this for you guys. I do this for the fans. I do it for the art. I do it for the fans, but I don't do it for money. So I'm gonna rip up every single dollar. Yeah, fuck you. All this money has me stressed out. This newfound fame and money has me stressed out about life. You know what? I want to start doing drugs. I want to start popping pills now.
Hey, wait.
What? What was that? Excuse me?
Yeah, you. I'm talking to you. I'm you from the future.
What?
Hey, I'm you from the future, and I think, that pills are bad and money is good. And you shouldn't rip up your money or, do pills in excess. You should, spend in moderation and, don't go to, any parties at Brian Singer's house.
Oh, too late.
God damn. I meant to go back further in the past. Okay, so, did you do that, like, ASMR album yet?
Oh, yeah, I'm almost finished. I'm almost finished with the album. I think it's gonna be like a really well-respected move. I think people are gonna like it.
Oh no! No! Don't put out an ASMR album. No! Don't do that. No.
What? I don't. Why? Why not? It's gonna be a short album. I'm not gonna like burn too much material on it. I think it's like. It's weird, but it's like accessible enough, you know.
No! Don't do that, please. Don't do this album, please.
I'm sorry. I feel like your voice isn't even like consistent, and I feel like the future me voice is like the dad voice. I feel like the future me voice and the dad voice are just the same voice. Wait. Are you you dad here?
What?
Are you the same dad I fell in love with earlier? That was me this whole time? That was future me?
Yes?
What? You could have told me.
I'm your dad.
What? No, you're not my dad. You're me. You're me from the future. I fell in love. I brushed my own hair. It's so gross. Okay, so that person I brought on stage was our child. That was my child. Everyone listening to this is my child. You are all my children. If you're listening to this, I'm your dad. I'm your dad. I'm your dad now. I'm your dad now. Thanks for having me.